Tonight's big story, a school board member in the Valley is now the subject of bullying, harassment, and threats, all because she is transgender.
Her gender identity has become a talking point and a target at recent school board meetings. Team 12's Bianca Bono attended the Liberty School Board meeting this week and sat down with the member who hopes the new year will bring an end to all the hate.
We saw multiple grade levels.
There are a few more passionate about education.
First grade picks up the text.
Then Paul Bexler.
My professional career has been in public education.
She started as a teacher in Phoenix in 1976, working her way up to administrator and principal. Paul now sits on the board for the Liberty Elementary School District in the West Valley.
I wanted to add some stability to the board.
Paul was motivated to come out of retirement and run for the school board seat in 2020 after watching the board face turnover and tough comments during COVID.
I figured with the expertise I was bringing in, it would be good stability.
At the end of 2022, she never could have predicted the comments would next target her.
Grooming and the trans ideology.
Trans grooming in our children's schools.
It is not the place to celebrate a grown man with a mental illness dressing as a woman.
Painful personal attacks.
I could not believe what they were saying.
All because she is a transgender woman.
I do not choose to be transgendered.
From the time Paul was a child, she knew she was different.
By about 11 or 12, I was pretty sure I knew what was going on.
That was in 1961.
There was too much risk.
Paul eventually married her wife, Candace, had two children, and a long, loving marriage.
My wife was aware of it, but it was absolutely clear that it was uncomfortable for her.
In 2017, Paul's wife died of cancer.
I decided at that point that if I was ever going to explore what my real feelings were, this would be the time.
At first, the support was overwhelming. But things changed at a November board meeting when public comment turned into this.
Until Paul Bexler resigns, I will continue to vote no.
Resign.
One of the speakers then escalating her comments on Fox News.
He grew his hair out a little bit and he wears his deceased wife's clothing to school.
Targeting not only Paul, but her late wife.
My wife was the gentlest, bravest, most grace-filled person I ever met. She incredible human being. And they attacked her.
From there, hateful emails and letters like this one.
Have you been afraid for your safety?
There were a couple of emails that got my attention.
But still, Paul continues to do her job.
We have to go back to Mr. Bexler.
At Monday night school board meeting, more comments.
Because he's still here.
But also words of support.
Please show some human decency.
Not sure we've had a board member who is as knowledgeable as Ms. Bexler.
Paul holding on to that positivity, refusing to resign, hoping speaking out at the start of a new year puts an end to the attacks.
This sideshow that they're trying to promote is taking away from the real business we ought to be doing. So I'd like to get back to the real job of a school board.
Bianca Bono, 12 News.
Bianca, thanks. We're tracking some breaking